Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video, we'll be working on a BMW 46 right here. And let me just start quick by telling you we will have more than 200 videos taking this whole car apart. So if you need anything from suspension work, engine work, interior, we'll have it on the channel. If not, drop a comment below guys, subscribe and we'll try to make that video for you. Now in today's video, we'll show you how to remove or how to replace mirror switch. Okay, the switch for the side view mirrors, this one right here. Most people will try to remove it, okay, without removing the door panel. Okay, but if you do, you're going to cause damage to your interior trim right here. I think, okay, this is from us when I try to pry. So do not do what I did. You can see I damaged ours. The safest way to do is to remove the door panel and access it from the back. And once we remove the door panel, I'll show you where all the clips are and where you need to pry if you want to try without removing the door panel, but you're on your own. So let's remove the door panel and I'll show you what to do next. All the parts and tools that we use guys will be listed in the description of the video below for your convenience. Now, since we'll be close to the airbag, what I'll recommend is to disconnect the car battery at least 30 minutes to 1 hour before you start working on any parts of the door that you face that way, because you don't want that airbag to blow in your face. So that will be the first thing that we will do. So let's go ahead, disconnect the battery. Now we need to pull that cover out of the trunk. Now usually right here guys, you have two clips, plastic clips that you need to pull out, but those are already missing, so you just need to remove the clips. Pull it out. This is your car battery right here. So we need to disconnect the negative terminal first, and after that we disconnect the positive. Now on the positive you have to be very gentle because it's part of the airbag system, and if you pull too hard on it, you can damage the connector. So you have to make sure that it's loose. Okay, this one should come out actually now. So I'll recommend using gloves. Okay, and you need to grab it for the terminal and pull it out. Now if you do it with your fingers and there is acid, it can severely burn your skin. So the next step will be to remove a few bolts now that we need to get a Torx. Okay, Torx in our case, let me see what this one is, 20. Torx 20, and there is a few screws that we'll need to remove. Okay, one right there. They're kind of in an angle sometimes, so it's hard to find them. Okay, you can see how they're in an angle, like that. It doesn't go straight, it goes a little bit up. Now, there is one more over there on the bottom side of the door handle. So that's where it's located. This is the second one. After that, there is a third one right here. Okay, I'm trying to see if I can focus with the camera inside, but I cannot get the angle. Okay, check out how the screwdriver is tilted a little bit. That's how the bolt is. We'll go ahead and remove this one too. Okay, perfect. Now, we need to remove that airbag cover. And there is a couple clips on this one, so you have to be very gentle how you remove it so you don't break it. So we'll just get a plastic trim removal tool like this one. That way we will minimize the damage to the plastic and we will avoid scratching it up. So let's go ahead and see actually, okay, which way the clips is. Because we want to avoid breaking it, so you have to take your time. Okay, those are the two clips you can see. And they're double clips on the bottom and the top. Now inside that cover there is another bolt there that we'll need to remove. And it is with the same Torx 2 that we used earlier. Okay, you can see how long this one is. After that, there is a screw under the interior door handle there. Perfect, just like that. So if you grab your panel with a panel remover tool or with your hands, if you can get them between the panel and the door, you can pry it out. And then here, it comes out this way as well. There is 6 clips on top. And you need to pull it out of the lock mechanism right here. So once you remove the door panel, you need to disconnect the cable for the interior door handle. So just pry this way or grab the tooth and push it towards the back. It will come out. After that, we need to disconnect the wires for the little speaker here. With a flathead screwdriver, there is a tooth that you pry out. You pull the wire out. After that, we need to disconnect the speaker wire by pressing both of those things in and pull it out. Now, the mirror switch, the easiest way to remove it is stick your finger in that hole and push up. When you push up, okay, the mirror switch will come out. Now, you can go ahead and disconnect that wire as well. Okay, just like that. And the door panel will come out of there, as you can see, just like that. Let me show you now how many clips we have on the back side. Okay, now some of them will be broken and we'll need to replace them. You can order replacement ones and I can share the link with you with the one that we will be using, so you can check them out. Now, you see right here you have a clip, here you have 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, one on the top 10, and we're missing one right here, 11. And then you have 6 little ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those 6 ones are the ones on top there. So all those clips will need to be, you need to make sure that you have them. This is a replacement one for the ones that are broken, you just slide them in. And if you have some left on the door in the holes, check that, you need to remove them. So with the door panel out of the way now, you can see this is the hole where the wire goes for the windows, for the mirror switch, my bad. Stick your finger there, push up. Okay, check it out now. It will come up. Now, you need to pull out the wire and here you need to disconnect the wire. There is one small tooth that you need to pry out with a flat head screwdriver, very little screwdriver, careful not to damage the clip. And the mirror switch will come out. Now, you can see there is 2 clips right here. Those 2 clips. And there is a place where you can pry underneath. So, what I'm going to do, I'll actually go ahead and attempt to do that and see if we can do it without removing the door panel. So, let's just give it a try now. I'm going to connect the wire and see if I can do it or I'm going to scratch something up. But I would recommend to go ahead actually and remove the door panel. So if you get a small knife, okay, you can pry one side up, but we caused some damage. So avoid that, guys. Just remove the door panel. Okay, that's what I would recommend. By removing the door panel, you stick your finger in the hole and you push it straight out. You can see how simple it is. So avoid that, don't damage your interior trim. So that's how you remove it and replace it. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Please subscribe and many more videos to come to the channel.